Hey everyone, it's Justin again. In the last lesson, you learned how to do automatic calculations in spreadsheets using formulas and functions. But it's hard to use functions if you don't actually know any. This lesson will teach you about the most useful functions for building a working budget. By the end of this lesson, you will be able to appropriately use spreadsheet functions to perform automatic calculations. This will include the sum, the SUMIF, the product, the average, and days functions. You learned your first function in the previous lesson, the sum function. If you type equals sum parentheses and link specific cells or a range of cells inside the parentheses, it will automatically add up the values in all the cells you selected, even if the numbers inside them change. There's also a more specific version of sum called SUMIF. SUMIF can be used to add up certain values while ignoring others. Like if you keep track of all of your expenses and want to know how much you spend just on food. The downside to SUMIF is that it requires a lot more setup. You have to choose what range to check for the selection criterion, decide what criterion to check for, and select the range to add up. In this case, we've chosen to base the criteria on the category column between B2 and B11. We only want to add the values that are categorized as food and the values to actually add together are in the cost column. This function adds up all the costs we've categorized as food and nothing else. To add up all the entertainment costs, we'd use the same function, just change the criterion to entertainment. SUMIF is good for sums where you don't feel like searching for specific cells. Let the spreadsheet do the searching for you. If you need to quickly multiply values, you can use the product function. Say we wanted to take your monthly student loan repayment and find out how much you pay every year. We would use the product function to multiply your monthly payment times 12 months per year. And then, if we wanted to know the total amount you'll spend repaying your student loans, we'd calculate a product again, this time between the yearly cost and the number of years. Notice that you still have to know which cells or numbers to use. The spreadsheet can't just read your mind. There's also a function to average a bunch of values. If you wanted to know the average amount you spent on groceries for the first half of the year, you would type equals average, then parentheses with the range of values you want to average linked inside. This is especially useful for costs that fluctuate from month to month because it gives you a good estimate of how much you should budget for it. If you budgeted $212 for groceries, some months you'd go a little over, and some months you'd go a little under. But over time, they'd even out, and you'll have budgeted almost exactly what you needed. This last one is optional, but especially if you expect to be on a tight budget, you'll want to know about the days function. Days automatically counts how many days there are between two dates, such as the day you get paid and the day a bill is due. Setting it up is pretty easy. Choose an end date for the calculation, then the start date. It sounds weird to put the end date before the start date, but it's important to remember. If my rent is due on the 1st and I get paid on the 31st, the days function tells me that I'll have to go 30 days from when that money leaves my account the next time I get paid. I can continue doing this for each of my bills. The days function is great for keeping an eye on how long you'll be short on money, so you can plan your bills and withdrawals and make sure you don't accidentally go over your budget. You may have already noticed, but throughout this video, I've been showing you different ways a budget can be set up. You could list all your bills and see what spending money you have left over. You might want to keep track of all your expenses to see where you could cut costs and save money. You can plan for the long term by taking your monthly payments and see how much they'll cost you over the years. You may choose to use past bills in order to estimate what your future bills will cost. Or you can be super specific and plan your budget by the day, especially if you're living paycheck to paycheck. These are all perfectly valid ways of budgeting, and it's up to you to decide which way works best for you. In the next few videos, you'll learn about the difference between fixed and variable expenses. And then we'll look at a few budgeting styles that many financial planners swear by, the 50-30-20 rule and envelope budgeting. See you then. Hey.